So the Americans will make a few changes here. We'll sort those out. But so South Africa, Great Britain, Germany, USA. The quota swim. The quota swim for South Africa. So that's fascinating. He's had the pick turn around like Phelps. Here he comes. He'll be feeling so good. Tired, yes. Emotional, maybe, but on a high in so many ways. So we know Townsend well from the 4x1. Russo, Leclerc.
Here is Team GB. Renwick, Lloyd, Bale and Davenport.
Haven't made a change, Nicole. The same four. Might have flipped the order a bit. Renwick to go first. He went last this morning.
I don't think they've got the depth to do it. The 100 and 23 was an event that they really struggled this year with. Tim
Wahlberger. So how come the Germans now? Just having a look here. Have they made a change? No, they've got the same four, but again, they've changed the order.
So Biedermann goes to the lead.
That's the anchor this morning.
Yeah, the anchor this morning.
Exactly. It's the same thing the Brits have done with Renwick. Now, here come the Americans now. How many new ones have they got? Only Conor Dwyer survived, so they go Lochte to Dwyer, who was the anchor this morning, to Behrens, into Phelps.
Phelps, anchor man, gives him a bit more time to recover too from the effort of the 200 butterfly.
So the French come out now. Laveau stays, Malay stays, Lefebvre stays, Agnel comes in. So the one change, Agnel comes in.
And he's had the warm-up in the 100 freestyle, making it through to the final with that.
And then the Australians, now they go Fraser Holmes, Monk, McKendry, Napoleon. So McKendry, Napoleon stay in, Fraser Holmes and Monk come in.
McKendry had the same time exactly as David McKeon in the heats, and they ended up picking McKendry. Disappointment for David McKeon, but a good opportunity for McKendry.
So China here, now they've got Hao comes in and Sun comes in. So the Chinese make two changes as well.
It's going to be a fascinating last leg with Sun Yang, Agnel and Phelps.
Wow. And so in come the Hungarians, and what have they done? Shea still there, Burnett. They've actually got the same four, they've just flip-flopped the order a bit. Yeah, that last leg. Say those names again. We've got
Phelps, Agnel, and Sun Yang.
Wow, well, that's the 200. The first two from the 200 and the champion
and
of the 200.
Phelps probably should have been in the 200 because he was leading the world rankings coming into this year, into this Olympic Games.
And I wonder how close it'll be when we get to there. And it's a fantastic prospect in front of us with these great names from these great swimming countries. Americans got the world record from Rome. It's very close. It was 1/100 faster than their world record from Beijing. 6:58.55.
It's a fast world record.
Hard to see it going, isn't it?
Yeah. The Olympic record.
Well, that's almost as fast, Nicole, because that was 6:56. 6:58.56. So there's no room.
Well, the gold medal's on offer.
And for Michael Phelps, a chance to get to a 19th Olympic medal, which nobody has ever achieved in any sport in the more than 100 years that the modern games have been going since 1896. And we're about to go in the men's 4x200 freestyle final.
Thank you, Mark.
Away, Townsend, South Africa 1, Renwick, Great Britain 2, Biedermann, Germany 3, Lochte, USA 4, Laveau, France 5, Fraser Holmes, Australia 6, Hao Yun from China 7, Cosma, Hungary in lane 8.
And it's the Frenchman, Laveau, taking them out in the lead. And really, if you look at the form of the first swimmers, it's Biedermann, Lochte and Laveau that the centre attention should be on. Lanes 3, 4 and 5. But South Africa, aren't they having a great night?
Well, Townsend has been a gold medalist in the 4x1, so he's got high speed. It's whether he can match it at the end of the 200. Fraser Holmes is there as well for Australia. He was a finalist in the 200. Now lane 4 starting to come through in Lochte. He has a narrow lead. He knows what it's like to lead the French, though. I think it's a good thing they haven't made him the anchor tonight.
Yeah, he wants to make sure he can make amends for that relay that he was leading and just couldn't hold on.
So he's got a good lead here over Australia and South Africa. So Lochte, Fraser Holmes and Townsend, a 1-2-3.
He is just so brilliant underwater, Ryan Lochte. They're under world record pace for the relay. For the first boys off the gun, this does count as an individual time, so it'll be interesting to compare Lochte's 200 freestyle time here to what went on in the individual.
Yep,
because this seems like a very convincing first lead.
Yes, it does. He was fourth in that freestyle final, and have a look at the margin. It is massive. It's 1.39. now Lochte in the final of the 200, ended up with a time of 145.04. Let's see what he does here.
Well, he's ahead of world record split for the relay. This has been a tremendous first leg. This is what you want as a relay swimmer for a lead.
So Lochte by about a body length at the moment. It's a massive margin. Fraser Holmes has had a good swim. So he is 145.04 and he's about the same here. It's Lochte from Australia and Germany. So USA, Australia, Germany. Now, in the water from the top, Rousseau of South Africa, Lloyd, Great Britain, Colopave of Germany, Dwyer, USA, Mallet, France, Monk, Australia, Lee from China and Shea from Hungary.
So those first splits, you had Thomas Fraser-Holmes at 146.13, Paul Biedermann in third to the wall, 146.15.
Well, that was a great swim for Fraser-Holmes in Australia. So USA, Germany and France. So moving up for France, Mallet.
Seems as though the gap that Ryan Lochte gave Connor Dwyer has really dwindled. Even after the first 50 metres, you start to think whether or not the German swimmer that's bridged that gap a little bit, whether or not he's gone a bit too hard in the first 100 metres.
Dwyer's split today was 145.52 when he anchored, so it was the fastest of the anchors today. So USA still with 1.12 over Germany and France, so it's Dwyer leading from Colopave and Mallet. They're the top three swimmers at the moment.
He paced that first 100 beautifully. Now really building this third 50. It was great underwater and he just pulled away from the opposition. So building in nicely to this last turn. Watch him underwater, the lead swimmer here, Connor Dwyer. Just fantastic underwater work.
And a great view there. So nearly 2 seconds the margin. They're about a second behind world record pace. So the USA with Dwyer. Now, Behrens to go next. He swam the individual. He's third in the Olympic trial behind Phelps and Lochte.
Great swim by Lee from China. He's really trying to get China into second position and overtake the Germans.
So Monk doing well for Australia as well. So it's USA clearly in front of Germany and Australia. So it's lanes 4, 3 and 6. So in the water, Le Clos for South Africa. The gold medalist from the 200 fly. Bale of Great Britain. This is from the top of the screen. Wahlberger, Germany. Behrens of the United States. Lefebvre of France. McKendry, Australia. Zhang of China. And Burnek of Hungary.
Now everything seems just a little bit calmer. Ricky Behrens is in the water. His technique is very smooth, very calm. Brings in a 6-beat kick, but from an arm point of view, it is just a fantastic technique to watch. He got the 200 freestyle spot when Michael Phelps withdrew. Phelps won the trials. Behrens got to race the 200 free. See him underwater, pulling through right down past the leg. Very balanced with his body position.
And a great battle going on for second and third. You can see that battle. They're a long way behind the Americans. So the USA with a substantial lead over Germany and Australia. But China is in the mix. And also it's Germany in the mix. And France in the mix and Australia. So a real battle for the minor medals. Michael Phelps is going to have a marvellous moment, I reckon. He's going to have a huge lead on his way to a gold medal.
And Ricky Behrens is doing the job for Team USA at the moment. A really nicely put together third 200 metres freestyle. Interesting to see the splits. Pushes down very deep, big butterfly kicks. What a margin, 2.74.
The best from Europe are chasing him in France and Germany at the moment. So the USA with this big lead, the French coming back. Now Agnew to go for France. He won the final of the 200 by such a margin.
He's not going to bridge this gap, but he may firm up France into a medal. Big moment for Michael Phelps.
It sure is. So the great one in the water, chasing the all-time Olympic record of 19 medals and a 15th gold. What a lead he's got. It's the USA with Phelps in the water. Agnew of France, the 200 individual champion, is in second placing. Rat goes in for Germany. Davenport for Britain, Napoleon for Australia, Sun Yan goes in for China. Expect him to be very strong.
It's probably worth having a look at this world record as well. Michael Phelps only needs to go around about the 144 and he's really lifting to this occasion to be close to that world record. Look at him bringing the big kick. This is what we're used to seeing. Michael Phelps, it's a loping stroke. The big 6-beat kick sitting beautifully high in the water.
I tell you what, Agnew's had a very big first 100 here. He's got some space between himself and the opposition. And the French, they were not close enough.
but they could get a little closer. USA with this huge lead over France. It's 2.84. It is insurmountable, but Agnel is making sure they get the silver. He can see Phelps now. He's 2.5 body lengths behind him.
It was around a 51-second first 100 for Michael Phelps, so that was a very fast first 100 metres for a 200-metre split.
Sun Yan's moved through to third place too for China.
Phelps
about to turn.
Underwater, butterfly kicking, he'll stay under. There's the 15-metre mark with the red dot on the lane rope. History.
It is. So Michael Phelps here with Yannick Agnel chasing him home. It's history of the best kind. So in over 100 years, nobody's won as many medals at the Olympic Games in any sport than this great champion, Michael Phelps. He makes it 19 tonight and a 15th gold. It's a place that nobody's been to before and maybe we'll never get to again. It's the USA, France and China. What a moment. Not just for swimming, not just for Phelps, but for the Olympics in total.
What a career. He celebrates. You've just witnessed history, Olympic history. And boys, be proud of that performance. That was just fantastic.
Lochte gets a ninth medal, so he's only 10 behind Michael, eh? Ah, what a moment.
Just a quiet moment of reflection for Michael Phelps.
All those hard yards, eh? And look at Mum and his sisters.
They know the significance of this.
Well, it's one of Olympic Games' greatest moments.
He's in a really good place, Bruce. You can just see it. He's so happy to be here. He's really relaxed.
I agree. I think his reactions tonight tell it all, don't you?
Ryan Lochte set it up for them in the opening 200 freestyle, almost as fast as his individual, gave a great lead to Connor Dwyer, who didn't panic when the rest came at him in the first 100 of his leg. This is Dwyer. He handed over to Ricky Behrens, who has just a glorious technique, great underwater, and he handed over to the man that has made history, Michael Phelps. We won't get to see him race too many more times, so it was nice at these Olympic Games to actually see him race and win. Got into swimming because of his sisters. They were both great swimmers. Big supporters along with Mum, Debbie.
Well, everybody has dreams, but nobody dreams of 15 Olympic gold medals and 19 in total. And it's a great reaction. And the last three swimmers, 1, 2, 3, were Phelps, Agnel and Sun Yan. Three of the really, well, the greatest, and then two that have made such a mark here already. That is just the best image imaginable.